Dobar dan. Today we'll learn the questions. Questions are extremely important. They are the basis of the conversation. To keep the conversation going on, we need to ask questions and answer the questions. So, question words and some vocabulary to be used as answers. First question is tko, ko, who. Tko si ti? Who are you? Tko je to? Who is that? You know the conjugation of the verb to be, so you can say I am, you are, he is. Tko si ti? Ja sam Azad. Tko je to? To je moj prijatelj. This is my friend. Also, in this video we'll be talking about this idea, the concept that the answer is within the question. So, using the question word to answer. Here is an example for the question tko, who. We can say nitko, no one, netko, someone, and svatko, everyone. Tko, nitko, netko, svatko. When using nitko, when using negative form, you need to keep in mind that there is double negative, like the sentences are made with a double negation. If you say no one is working, and you say no one don't work. Nitko ne radi. Netko radi, someone works. Svatko hoće pričati bosanski. Everyone will speak Bosnian. Yeah, try to make few sentences with the things you already know. Practicing is important. Next question is što, šta, what? Što radiš? Very common question. What do you do? Or what are you working on? Šta je to? What is that? The answer again, see, ništo is nothing, nešto something, and svašto is everything. Što? Ništa. That could be an answer. Što radiš? Pa ništa. I'm just doing nothing. Ništa ne radim. Next question is kako? How? Kako si? How are you? How would you answer this question? Usually it's very good, odlično, dobro, good, u redu, all right, loše, bad. Kako si? Or kako ste? How are you, if you want to be polite, or asking a group of people. Odlično, dobro sam, u redu, loše. Three more words that are made out of the question. Kako? Nikako. No way. No how, literally. There is no how, there is no possibility, no way. Nekako, somehow. Svakako, anyhow, anyway. The next question is gdje, where. Now I need to warn you that there is three type of where questions. We'll get to them, but this one is where is, like where is it, where is that, gdje, gdje si ti, where are you, gdje je to, where is that. The answers here: nigdje, nowhere, negdje, somewhere, svugdje, everywhere. This is actually the one that's the most similar to English, because we also have where as a question here, and then nigdje, nowhere, negdje, somewhere, and svugdje, everywhere. There are two more ways to ask the where question. Odakle is where from. Odakle si, where are you from. Kamo, where to. Kamo ideš, where are you going to. No, maybe kamo is not that common, but odakle question for foreigners, pretty sure that you will be hearing sometimes, like where are you from. Odakle si. Next question is kada, or kad, when. Kada hoćemo popiti kavu, when will we drink coffee. Multiplicating vocabulary that you can use in many cases: before, now, and after. Prije, sada, posle. I did that before. Yasam to radio priye. Another three words would be yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And the day before yesterday and the day after tomorrow, they formed with the word preko, which means over. So when they say day before yesterday, they say the day over yesterday. Danas jučer preko jučer. The same. Danas sutra preko sutra. The day over tomorrow. And also, of course, the words that are created with the help of the question itself. Never, nikad, once, nekad, at some point also, once or at some point, nekad, and uvijek, always. Nikad, nekad, uvijek. And there's also ponekad, sometimes, time to time. Next question is koliko? How many? How much? Koliko košta? Koliko godine imaš? You can guess koliko košta is how much does it cost? Koliko košta ovo? How much does this cost? Koliko godine imaš? How many years do you have? So how old are you? And to answer the koliko question, we need to get to know the numbers. I think it's very logical and very easy. They're skipping some letters sometimes when written, but generally we could say that if you learn the numbers from 1 to 10 and the word najest ending that you add, you can say pretty much everything till 99. First, you need to learn the numbers from 1 to 10. I'll read it. Jedan, dva, tri, četiri, pet, šest, sedam, osam, devet, deset. Now, to make the numbers from 11 to 19, you need to add this najest after the word that you're saying. So 11 would be jedan najest, dva najest is 12, tri najest, četiri najest, and so on. To say 20, you're literally saying 2 tenths. So dva deset, 21, dva deset jedan. 30, tri deset, četiri deset, pet deset, and pet deset tri, 53. Then we have 100 is sto, sto, dva sto, tri sto, četiri sto, same principle as with the tens. Dva sto, tri sto, pet sto, 500. I would like to ask you, how old are you? Try to write how old are you in the comments, just to practice. Here also, to say 1,000, 1,000, there is two ways. First one is more Croatian, tisuća, and the other one is more Serbian, hiljada. Just choose the one that you like more. Everybody in Balkans will anyway understand what you mean, whether you're saying tisuća or hiljada. It would be also 2000, 3000, 2000, 3000. And also, still the same question, koliko, how many, how much, we can use to make words. Nikoliko, none, nekoliko, several or some, nekoliko, and sve, all, like everything. The word sve also can be used to describe everybody, everything. Sve. Next question is zašto? Why? Zašto učiti bosanski? Why are you learning Bosnian? For what? The answer usually starts with zato što. Because. Zašto? Zato što. To je to. To su bili pitanja. That were the questions. Doviđenje. Vidimo se.